What's up everyone, Jonas here for Thomann Synthesizers. So in today's video, we will dive into the world of FM synthesis. And for that, I brought three different units with me from three different price ranges to compare if cheaper ones are delivering as much as higher priced ones, the sound quality, haptic, etc. So if you are relatively new to this topic of FM synthesis, then I would advise you to check out a video that Felix actually made a while ago, which is comprehending really well the backstory, techniques and theory of FM synthesis. So I will link that somewhere here. And afterwards, maybe you want to come back to check out a unit which you can make the most use of. All right, without further ado, let's jump right in and let's start with the first unit, the Korg Volker FM, which is the cheapest of all three. So here we have the Korg Volker FM, and it's actually the first unit from the Volker series which finds its way into my studio, but I guess it's nothing new for the most of you and could be kind of familiar. Anyway, I was really curious to compare it to higher price range synthesizers in the FM world. Moreover, I was really skeptical because it's really low priced with, I think, just 140 euro. And the first touch is, as you might think, really kind of plastic. The finishing is not the best, but for the price, I think it's totally reasonable and understandable why it is like this. So the layout is really straightforward, not too many knobs and a small display. Here you will find the modulator with attack and decay, and next to it, the carrier with the attack and decay, the LFO with rate and depth, the program and algorithm, as well as it is capable of programming an arpeggiator. So you actually don't find a filter or a cutoff knob. And this is actually quite common because we are in the FM world. And this is actually the difference to subtractive synthesis, because here in FM, we start with something really kind of boring, let's say, not too much harmonics, and we will layer or stack them with different operators. So the carrier is the one that you hear, and the modulator is the one which is modulating or affecting the carrier. So the Volker FM has six operators and only sine waves as in the traditional FM. For the algorithms, we can choose in between 32 different algorithms. As said, I was really curious at the beginning because of its price, but let's convince ourselves. The Volker FM has 32 different storage memories, and all of them are coming with factory presets, and it's quite difficult actually to create your own patch, but we will do this later on. I was just checking through it, and I think there are actually some of them are quite interesting, such as the Cubase. So let's check it out. So let's play a little bit with decay, and we see here it gets shorter as a usual normal decay and longer. But if we now increase or decrease the rate of the modulator decay, the overall sound has a switch, because now the decay is really low. There is nothing happening later on really. But if we increase it, we see that we actually add harmonics to the sound. I have to say, I was really surprised by its low end. If we take it down an octave or two, let's see how that sounds like. And I think that is actually really... really something, really rich, really strong, saturated. So let's create our own patch. And I found out that in the Volker FM, it's by using the small display menu. It is actually quite difficult because you just have shortcuts and you have to press actually every time different key to access the thing you want. But there are different softwares or apps that you could apply from an iPad or a Mac or a computer to create patches from the scratch. So let's check that out. So all you have to do is actually just connecting it by MIDI, and the software is sending then sysx messages to your unit. And actually by using this and being aware of that the VolkFM is capable of receiving CC messages, you are having actually not a toy, but a really, really standing out tool, in my opinion, for a small budget. So let's create something on the fly. I was thinking of a pad or something like a string. And in here you can choose in between your algorithms, as you see on the top left. So here we have the keyboard. And we can hear slow rise, not too much harmonic content. Let's bring up the second operator. And we can hear the rise of the additional harmonics. So let's detune this a little bit to have it a bit richer. So let's increase the third as well. Yeah, maybe we have a rise of the harmonics here again and a fall around this point. And then let's modulate the modulator. And now we can actually save this into our VolkFM and then sequence it. All right, let's go into the Eurorack world a little bit and let's patch the Hertz Donut Mark III. Let's check out my patch. As you can see, I was using the Octatrack by Electron to sequence it. So I was simply sending MIDI messages to the yarns by Mutable Instruments. And then I split this up by CV and gate into my multiplier. And from there I was triggering the Hertz Donut, of course with the CV signal, but also I was using the gate signal for the fold and also for the mod CV to have it a bit of variation in it, and to trigger the phase distortion and the umbrage a little bit in the operators. And afterwards, actually, it was going into the Morgasmatron because to have it more plucky. I know it's not like FM-ish, but anyway, I was using the low-pass filter to have it a bit more plucky. And from there, I was going into the Herbwerk by Make Noise, and I was also using the mix output from the Hertz Donut to trigger the reverse signal of the reverb. And from there on, I was going into the Rainmaker by IntelliJam to have this kind of bongo drive somehow using the comm filter, and I was playing a little bit with the dry wet signal, and this was actually going into the beats by Mutable Instruments, which is set a little bit of a higher pitch to have kind of more melodic touch to it for some phrases, and to have some more weirdness going on, I was using the Data Bender by Qubit. So here we have the Herz Donut FM phase distortion module by Industrial Music Electronics, and with round about 540 euro, it's in between of the other two pieces of gear. But you have to keep in mind, of course, that this is just voice for Eurorack, and of course you have to add on some more stuff in order to get actually your sounds out or signals in. But I think, in my opinion, that the Herz Donut is really, really interesting when it comes to tonal shaping, exploring sounds, because the harmonic content you can get from it is really kind of extreme, but in a way really beautiful and saturated, and perhaps maybe kind of uncommon because it's such an extreme one. But I really like it, especially the phase distortion and the umbrage section, which is really strong, but at the same time really interesting. For the operators, you will have the four parameters: main oscillator frequency, operator frequency, phase distortion, and umbrage. Both have the same one, so you have to, in order to change them, you have to keep in mind the display, because it's the same setting for both of them. So moreover, you will find the fold button, which lets you work on the distortion, the umbrage, so adding a lot of harsh harmonic overtones, and resonance, also known from filters, of course. As well, of course, plenty of modulation, jack inputs, you can trigger them or send LFOs in it, etc., etc. So let's send some signals into it. Some CV. Let's send some triggers to it. So next up, let's check out the Kodamo Essence FM, which is a rack-sized FM synthesizer, and I'm really curious what you will think of it. So here we have the Kodamo Essence FM, and with 1,500 euro, it's the most expensive of all three units. The crazy thing is actually that it has a 300 voice polyphony, and I think that's really something. I have to say that I am actually someone who likes one function per knob, and I'm not that much into displays, and when I found out that this is actually touch, I was like, oh yeah, really kind of surprised and kind of overwhelmed at the beginning, but I have to admit it is pretty useful and really futuristic, and you will get used to it. Actually, I think for what it does, it is pretty helpful to have it touchable, because you can touch multiple things at once and yeah, create layers and stack everything. But let's check it out. So for the global overview, you will find voice, patch and performance. So in voice, you can create your own voice with 6 different operators in different algorithms. In patch, you can layer them up. And in performance, you can perform different patches at once with MIDI. So let's check out the voices. You have some pre-installed and you can scroll through the list in here, but also with the knob in here. And from the F or G bank on, it's actually free. In here, we can create our own voice. As said, you can here choose in between different algorithms with the knob, but actually you can have a crazy amount of different algorithms by creating them yourself with just using your finger and connecting them and doing something like this. And you see there actually you need touch. So you can do crazy things actually. I don't know if that makes sense, but you can do whatever you feel like to. You can do it in here. So you can connect whatever you want. A crazy network of operators, carriers, whatever. I think this is only possible in this one. And yeah, makes it really futuristic. So you can choose in between 28 different waveforms. You can see here is the one, so we can scroll with the knob in here, but we can also do it like this. So let's go for something maybe more rich. Yeah, harmonic song, I think is nice. So in here we have the volume or the envelope, and by pressing plus, we can actually add something. So in here, we could actually also add a filter if you would like to. All right. So in here, we could now like, yeah, create patches, and in here you can now perform them with up to 16 different channels with MIDI. So let's go for this. In here is the new patch, playing some chords sent from the octa track. So you can create beautiful pictures of FM synthesis with the Kodamo. Alright, that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it and that I could deliver a small overview on those 3 units. I really enjoyed working with all of them, the cheaper one, the Eurorack one, and especially actually the Kodamo, which yeah, kind of surprised me because I was a little bit scared of the display and everything, but the sound of it is really fantastic. So if you have any questions regarding all of those 3, please comment them and I will get back to it. So thanks a lot for watching and see you next time.